So, wala mo na? So, kung wala, anyway, you can also ask later on, no? So, ang topic natin ngayon ay compassion. And this is also because of the colorga times na nandiyan yung problema natin sa drug addiction at ang solusyon ay wala nang pag-asa yan, patay na lang. At saka nandiyan din yung problema natin sa death penalty na marami rin at mga dapat the cream of the crop, ang ating mga lawmakers ay naniniwala na ang solusyon sa kriminalidad ay pagpatay. No? So parang walang compassion. And that happened immediately after the Jubilee of Mercy. No, parang ibig sabihin, parang walang epekto yata yung celebration ng Jubilee of Mercy. And it happened after after the WACOM, the World Congress on Mercy na ginawa dito sa atin. No? So, bakit ganon? No? At saka ito ay dapat Christian country pa. At ang masama, hindi lang sa maraming pinapatay, hindi lang sa gusto ng death penalty, parang maraming Pilipino sumasang-ayon. Parang okay lang, so, ibig sabihin yung kultura natin, may problema pa. No? So, we'll try to see ano ba dapat ang biblical teaching dito sa compassion, okay? Kanina, may nagtanong sa atin na yung Old Testament daw ay parang mabangis yung Diyos. No? Nandiyan yung mga God as a warrior, God as a punisher. Pero kung titingnan natin, ang compassion is also a theme, an important theme of the Old Testament. Not just of the New Testament. Ang ibig sabihin ng semantic camp, yung semantic camp, ang ibig po sabihin yan, ito po yung mga group of words, kaya campo, semantic words, campo, that would somehow have related meanings. Kaya ang compassion belongs to the semantic camp of tenderness, mercy, graciousness, ready to forgive, steadfast love. So, yan lahat ay kaugnayan sa compassion. And since we are using different Bibles, no, these different Bibles have different translations of many Hebrew words that are related to each other. And these are their relationships, the mga words. So, they belong to the same semantic camp. No? So, they share the same characteristics, the same meaning. So in the Old Testament, God is presented as compassionate. Kaya nga sa Exodus, when God introduced himself, remember what happened in Exodus? Moses went to Mount Sinai, but people could not wait for 40 days and 40 nights. So they asked Aaron to make the golden calf, and Moses came down with the tablets of the laws, and then when he saw them, he broke the tablet and got angry with the people for having turned their back to God and worship another God. And God wanted to kill the people already, but then Moses prayed, mediated to God for the people, and he went back again to the mountain, and God gave him again the law, and he asked God to show him his face, to assure him of his love for the people. And God revealed himself to Moses. God said, you will not see my face, because if you see my face, you die, but you will see my back. And I passed by, he pronounced these words. The Lord passed before him and proclaimed, the Lord, which is Yahweh, no? So, Lord is a translation for Yahweh. They could not pronounce the proper name of God, so they called him as Adonai, which translated directly would mean Kyrios, or Lord. So the Lord, a God merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness, keeping steadfast love for the thousand generations, forgiving iniquity and transgressions and sins, yet by no means clearing the guilty, but frequently visiting the iniquity of the parents upon the children and the children's children to the third and fourth generation. So this is the revelation of God to Moses. Ito yung pagpapakilala. Sino ba siya? So the Lord, Yahweh. At dito makita na natin yung semantic hub of compassion. He is great, merciful, gracious, slow to anger, abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness, forgiving iniquities. So iyan yung Diyos. He did not present himself as a strong God. He did not present himself as a ferocious God, as a vengeful God, but as a forgiving God. So many people have stressed this, visiting the iniquity of parents upon the children's children to the third and fourth generation, because the merciful God is also a just God. So, kaya pinagpaparusa siya, and in those times, they were not yet having that revelation of the life after death as a punishment and reward. Kaya ang punishment and reward is happening in our lifetime. Ay kung hindi maparusahan, if the person is not punished, then the punishment goes to his children and grandchildren up to the third and fourth generation. Ay ang higpit naman. But try to contrast this. He gives his steadfast love to the thousand generation. The contrast is between the thousand generation and the fourth generation. There is no comparison. But the problem is many people don't see this thousand generation of steadfast love. They only see the fourth generation of punishment. Yes, God does punish because He's also just. No, He does not let things pass. Pananagutan din natin yan. No, but His mercy is more, no, than His punishment. More, thousand to the fourth generation. Look at that comparison. No, kaya, that's why we have the idea that God is a vengeful God, because we stress only those parts of the Old Testament, the stress that God punishes. But there are more things that show that God is merciful. Nehemiah, they refused to obey and were not mindful of the wonders that you performed among them, speaking about the generation that went out of Egypt. But they stiffened their necks and determined to return to their slavery in Egypt. Even while God was bringing them out to freedom, they still wanted to go back to Egypt. But you are a God ready to forgive, gracious and merciful, slow to anger, abounding in steadfast love, and you did not forsake them. You did not forsake them. So you see that in spite of the stiff-neckedness of the people, still God helped them. This is one thing that I would like to stress, this steadfast love or faithful love. In Hebrew, there is a special word for that, and the special word for that is Chesed. No, and it's translated as faithful love or steadfast love. So Chesed is a kind of love that you can depend on, that you can go back and still that love is there. That's why it's steadfast love, faithful love. Hindi matampuhin. Hindi tulad natin, no? Nagtampo. At tapos kailangan mo pang balik-balikan, no, para amuhin, no, para mahalin ka uli. Ang Diyos, hindi mo kailangan amuhin. No, even if you commit sin against Him, when you go back to Him, His love is always there, steadfast, maaasahan. No? So, yan po yung kanyang pag-ibig sa atin. Second Chronicles. For as you return to the Lord, your kindred and your children will find compassion with their captors and return to this land. For the Lord your God is gracious, merciful, and will not turn away his face from you if you return to him. And this was said, now, to the people of Israel when they were exiled after they have sinned against the Lord. They were exiled to Babylon. But then God said, if you return to him, God is merciful and gracious. He will not turn his face from him kung bumalik kayo sa kanya. So it's not only referring to their experience in Egypt, but also their experience when they turn away from the Lord. Now, during the time of the exile. And the Psalms. But you, O Lord, are a God merciful and gracious, slow to anger, abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness. So you see, they always go back, now, to this pronouncement of God to Moses. These characteristics of God. And this is only one from the Psalms. There are so many other similar sayings in the Psalms, similar prayers. And we who pray the liturgy hours are familiar with this idea about God. Merciful and gracious. No? So, he has gained renown by his wonderful deeds. The Lord is gracious and merciful. The word gracious, which we use in English, is coming from grace. And you know that grace, ay libre, biyaya. It is not something that we deserve. It is given to us freely. Ayan ang Diyos. Mapagbigay. So para yan mapagbiyaya, mapagbigay. No? And merciful. Okay? Gracious is the Lord and righteous. Our God is merciful. So you see this, how constantly it is being repeated. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, abounding in steadfast love. So it's a kind of a refrain that we see in the Pentateuch, that we see in the historical books, that we see in the prophetic books, and that we see in the prayers, no, of the people of Israel. Ito, prophetic books. Rend your hearts and not your clothing. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, abounding in steadfast love, and relents from punishing. This is our reading during Ash Wednesday. Rend your hearts and not your clothing, your garments. Because for the people to show their sorrow and to show their rage, kapag galit sila, pinupunit nila ang damit nila. Ganun sila kagalit. No, but instead of rending your clothing, your garment, yung puso nyo. No, ang dapat biyakin nyo. Because God is merciful. No, and He is not happy in punishing. He's not happy in punishing. Jonah, he prayed to the Lord and said, O Lord, is not this what I said while I was still in my own country? This is why I fled to Tarshish at the beginning, for I knew that you are a gracious God and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love, and ready to relent from punishing, to go away from punishing. Ito yung dahilan, Jonah was scandalized by this characteristic of God. Because he wanted to punish Nineveh. Because Nineveh was their enemy. They had done a lot of wrong. Nineveh destroyed Samaria. Exiled the 10 tribes of Israel. So when there was a threat that Nineveh would be punished, and Jonah was sent to Nineveh in order to warn the people of Nineveh, he did not want to go. That's why he went to the opposite side. He went to Tarshish, not to Spain. Instead of going to the east, he went to the west. No, why? And he gave the reason. Ito kasi kaya kong tumakas, kasi alam ko, mapagpatawad ka. No? So finally, when he was forced to go back, no, and he preached, and you know, he was half-hearted. Nineveh was so big that it will take you 3 days to walk across the city. He walked only for 1 day. 1/3 lang ang kanyang inabot. And his message was even not giving a lot of hope. He was saying, 40 days more and the city will be destroyed. 40 days more. Walang sinabing repent. No. Yet, this is definitive. But then the people, they tried. Kahit na ganun ang mensahe, they tried. Perhaps God is merciful. Let us be sorry. And everybody was sorry, from the king up to the beast. No, pati yung mga beast na nag-ayuno, hindi sila kumain. And maybe God forgave. And then here, Jonah complained to God, this is the reason why, because I know that you are merciful and I don't want them to receive mercy. I don't want them to receive. So he was scandalized by this characteristic of God. No? So even the enemy, if they just ask for mercy, they won't be pardoned. At ayaw niya. No? So that's the Old Testament. So let us disengage ourselves from that idea that the Old Testament God is a punishing God. No, he relents from punishing. He does not want to punish. Now, Jesus is the image of God. He concretizes to us the compassion of God. Jesus is the invisible, is the visible image of the invisible God. So God became visible in Jesus. That's what we mean by he became human. God became visible in Jesus. So in Colossians, he has rescued us from the power of darkness and transferred us into the kingdom of his beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. That's why if Jesus is the image of the invisible God, he makes God visible. What he made visible was the God who is compassionate. Because that is the characteristic of God in the Old Testament. No? So yan din parehong Diyos, hindi nagbago. That's why we have redemption through Him. So He made that clear to us. Now, the compassion of Jesus is shown by His actions and by His words and by His teachings. We see that in Jesus we have the revelation in words and works. So let us show first the compassion in the actions of Jesus. Then Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues and proclaiming the good news of the kingdom and curing every disease and every sickness. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion for them because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few." I only took several examples, but many actions of Jesus have been prompted by His compassion, by His mercy. He is moved. Kaya siya nag-a-act because He was touched. And here when He saw the crowd, He had really compassion with them. Kawawa naman. Litong-lito. Naghahanap ng guidance. Harass na harass. And hopefully we also get that kind of attitude of Jesus when we see our people. Litong-lito, naghahanap. Naghahanap ng makakapitan. So we should have compassion towards them. And because of this compassion, we should be all the more zealous in what we do to help them out. No? Then Jesus called his disciples to him and said, "I have compassion for the crowd because they have been with me now for 3 days and have nothing to eat. And I do not want to send them away hungry, for they might faint on the way." So nakikita niya ang sitwasyon nila, kasakasama, walang pagkain. So it would not just send them away to go home as his disciples wanted. No, kasi ang dami ng mga tao, 5,000. Wala naman tayong may papakain sa kanila. Pauwiin mo na para kanya ka na silang maghanap. No, you feed them. You feed them. Jesus had compassion on them. Nakikita niya ang sitwasyon nila. Nararamdaman niya. So this is part of his characteristic. As he approached the gate of a town, to a man who had died was being carried out. He was his mother's only son, and she was a widow. With her was a large crowd from the town. When the Lord saw her, he had compassion for her and said to her, "Do not weep." Yan yung the red rising of the son of the widow in the inn. You know that in their culture, the value of the woman is depending on the man to him to whom she is attached. So the woman by herself has no value in their society. So if she were still a child or a virgin, then she would depend on the father. The father gives her standing in their society. Then if she is married, then the value depends on the husband. And then if the husband dies, then on her male son, because the woman could not transact any business, could not own anything. So it's through the man. Kaya talagang kawawa-kawawa, kaya marami ang nakisama sa libing. No, so many went to the funeral because they saw that this woman's pitiful. She was already a widow. Wala nang tatay, wala nang husband. And she depend only on the son. And the only son died. So they were not only sorry for the son. Anyway, the son was still young. They're also sorry for her, for him. But not only for him, they're also sorry for the woman herself. What will happen to her? What will she be? She would have nobody in her life now. So when the group of Jesus met this group, Jesus was going to the city, the group was going out of the city, he stopped, and without being asked, he himself took the initiative to come to the woman and to touch the dead and to raise the dead and to bring the dead back to the mother. He took the initiative. Why? Because he had compassion. Naawa din siya. But you know, already I would forward it, that you cannot have compassion if you don't know the situation. Kaya madalas, walang compassion kasi hindi natin alam ang sitwasyon. Ibig sabihin si Jesus, inaalam niya ang sitwasyon ng mga tao. They have been with me for 3 days. At ito siguro tinanong niya rin, sino yung patay? Bakit ang dami nakilibing? So he knows their own situation. So that's the actions of Jesus. Now, in the teachings of Jesus, to show the compassion, so the slave fell on his knees before him saying, "Have patience with me, I will pay you everything." And out of pity for him, the Lord of the slave released him and forgave him the debt. This is the parable about the unforgiving servant. Now that servant owed the master 10 talents, which is the equivalent of 10 million pesos. So big, 10 million pesos, that's in the translation of the Tagalog Bible, 10 million pesos. And yet, nagmakaawa siya. Have patience with me. I will pay you everything. Just to think about it, how could you pay 10 million pesos? Pero hindi lang sa naniwala ang master sa kanya, pinatawad pa. But the great irony is that he who was forgiven 10 million could not forgive 500 pesos. Because when he saw a fellow slave who owed him 500, pinakulong niya pa. That's why when this was brought to the master was so angry with him. Ang laki ng patawad sa'yo. That's why Jesus said, you should forgive not only 7 times, but 70 times 7. Why? Because we are forgiven so much. God forgives us so much. So can you not just forgive so little? Also, he had teachings about forgiveness. No? And then his Lord summoned him and said to him, you wicked slave, I forgave you all the debt because you pleaded with me. You did not have mercy on your fellow slave as I had mercy on you. Kaya yung katuruan niya, be merciful as your Father is merciful. As you have received mercy, be merciful. Pinatawad ka, hindi ka pa pwedeng magpatawad. No? But a Samaritan, while traveling, came near him. And when he saw him, he was moved with pity. This is part of the Samaritan, the good Samaritan. So, when that man was left half dead by the road, a priest came, saw him, and moved along. A Levite came, saw him, and moved along. These are supposed to be religious people, the priest and the Levite. No, they are busy with the temple, with the things of the temple, and yet they saw and went by. But there's a difference. When the Samaritan came, he saw and was moved with pity. He did not only see, but seeing, he was moved with pity, so he stopped and took care of him. Because there was pity. Mayroong awa sa kanya. Which of these three do you think was a neighbor to the one who fell into the hands of robbers? He said, the one who showed him mercy. Jesus said to him, go and do likewise. So this parable was occasioned by the question of the lawyer. What is the greatest commandment? Love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your own souls, and love your neighbor as yourself. Who is my neighbor? And he gave this parable. That's why at the end of the parable, he asked now, who is the neighbor? Which was a neighbor to the one who fell to the hands of the robbers? The one who showed mercy. Hindi niya nga masabi na Samaritan. Kasi nakakahiya, no? Ang bida, Samaritan pa, kalaban ng mga Hudyo. But the one who showed him mercy. Siya yung nagpapakita na siya yung neighbor. No. That's why we become neighbor when we have mercy, when we have compassion. And the mercy comes from within. When within, in Hebrew, ang ginamit nila splagna, splagnistai, which is the entrails coming out. No, it is a movement of the inside coming out. When you are really moved, no? Hindi mo mapigilan, napapaiyak ka, napapalabas yung damdamin mo. Yan yung mercy, yan yung mercy. No? That's why he said, blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. So, yan yung ating theme sa Jubilee of Mercy. And he said, go and learn what this means. I desire mercy, not sacrifice. I have not come to call not the righteous, but the sinners. No. In order to show mercy, why does he love the sinners? Because he came to show mercy. Ang righteous, hindi na kailangan ng mercy. Bigyan mo na lang, justice na yan. But he has not come for that, but he has come for mercy. Yung walang-wala para sa kanilang sarili. He called sinners. So that was Jesus, who is the concrete image of the invisible God. So by his actions and by his teachings, pinakita niya yung mercy. Ngayon, ano naman teachings ng mga apostles? So what is good among the apostles? Nakuha ba nila yung ugali ni Jesus? Did they get the teachings of Jesus? Yes. So, from St. Paul, "For God is my witness, how I long for all of you with the compassion of Christ Jesus." So, God is my witness. He was swearing. "I swear to God that I long for you with the compassion of Jesus." Ganun yung awa ko sa inyo. Yung awa ni Jesus ay nasa akin. Just think about that. It's not His own mercy, but to the compassion of Jesus that I'm longing for you. I'm merciful to you with the mercy of Jesus for you. Romans, "Just as you were once disobedient to God, but have now received mercy because of their disobedience, so they have now been disobedient in order that by the mercy shown to you, they too may now receive mercy. For God has imprisoned all in disobedience so that He may be merciful to all." He was speaking here about the Jews and the Gentiles. The Gentiles were disobedient to God. They did not recognize God. But God had mercy on them. Now the Jews are disobedient to God. They did not accept Jesus. But God also will have mercy on you. So that God, all of us, imprisoned in disobedience, may God may show mercy to all of us. Kung kayong magmayabang, kayong mga Hudyo, no, na kayo lang ang bayan ng Diyos. Kasi disobedient din kayo. Hindi kayo sumunod sa batas. Huwag kayong magmayabang, you who are Gentiles, because you received Christ and they did not receive. Because you were also before disobedient, you did not receive, you worship other gods. So all of you are imprisoned in disobedience so that God may be merciful to all. One problem why probably people do not no longer appreciate the mercy of God because they have lost the sense of sin. They have lost the sense of sin. What do you mean by that? Two things. One, they have not seen the evil of sin. Parang ang sin okay lang, basta hindi ka lang mauli. That's why it's okay to cheat as long as you're not. It's also okay to cheat in marriage as long as your wife does not know. It's okay to be corrupt as long as you are not corrupt. They don't see the evil of sin, how much damage you do to other people. And secondly, the loss of the sense of sin is that they don't see that they have sinned. Parang hindi naman malaki bagay. Hindi naman kasalanan. There is no fear of sin. Because they've lost the sense of sin, therefore they have lost the sense of being forgiven. Kaya hindi ko na kailangan mag-umpisa. Wala na mong kasalanan. Hindi na kailangan mag-umpisa. And that's because they have lost the sense of sin, they have lost the sense of asking forgiveness, so they have lost the sense of joy of being forgiven. Which is the joy of the gospel. That na napalaya ka. Napalaya ka. You were saved. Kaya balik-balikan natin muli yan. So all of us were imprisoned in disobedience. So God is merciful to all of us. And we appreciate what God has done to us. 1 Timothy. "But for that very reason, I receive mercy, so that in me, foremost, Jesus might display the utmost patience, making me an example to those who would come to believe in Him for eternity." So here, St. Paul was quoting himself as the example today. That is our first reading, his conversion. So he realized that I was a sinner. I persecuted the church of God. I was the greatest sinner of all, yet God has shown mercy to me. In spite of what he has done, he has called me. He has given me this grace to preach the good news. Not only he has forgiven me, but he did not lose his trust in me. That he made me an apostle so that I can be an example to all. No matter how low you have fallen, you can still rise up. You are still useful. Maybe looking back in your own personal history, you can probably also relate with St. Paul. How you were when you were still young. Maybe you didn't care about God. Maybe you have done something very wrong. And yet God entrusted you with a mission. Not only forgiven you, but called you, entrusted you with a mission. Kaya pwede niyo masabi sa iba, don't lose hope. That's why we can also say, no, even if he's a drug lord, if he was a drug pusher or drug addict, no, malakas ang grasya ng Diyos. The grace of God is stronger. He can make use of this, and so many of our own people are eager about this. In Archdiocese of Manila, we have a priest who is in charge of our San Lakbay, our program for rehabilitating the drug addicts, and he's so very enthusiastic about this and full of energetic about this because he himself had been a drug addict. He himself had been a drug pusher. No. Nakulong din siya. Nagbayad din siya sa mga pulis. Nakibigay ng mga pulis na natutulog lamang siya sa bilangguan at sa araw nakakalabas din siya. Tutuloy sa mga drug, sa kanyang drug dealings as long as nagbibigay siya sa mga pulis. That was his experience. And in spite of that, God called him and became a priest. So he's so eager to help these people. May pag-asa kasi niya rin nasan ko yan. You know, even for us, we had a priest before who was so eager in hearing confession because he saw in his life how confession has helped him. Paano siya natulungan ng kumpesal? Kaya palagi siya nagpapakumpesal. So his own experience of receiving mercy, he also became an instrument of mercy. Kaya balikan din natin ang ating karanasan sa ganito. So St. Paul goes back to that. Letter to the Hebrews. Therefore, he had to become like his brothers and sisters in every respect, so that he might be a merciful and faithful high priest in the service of God, to make a sacrifice of atonement for the sins of the people. He was speaking about Jesus, the high priest. Jesus was a high priest who offered himself because he knew the human condition. He became man and like us in all things except sin. But even if he did not commit sin, he also experienced the result of sin. He also became weak. He also was tempted. He also became sick. He also was a victim of the sins of others. So kahit hindi siya nagkasala, but he also felt in his own experience the results of sin, ang kasamaan ng kasalanan, even being putting him to death. And because of this experience, like his brothers and sisters in every way, so he is a merciful and faithful high priest. That's why we can pray to Jesus more, because he knows our human situation. He knows our weaknesses. Before his coming, probably, when people pray to God, hindi naman alam lang Diyos ang pagkatao natin. Will he really identify with us? But now we cannot say that anymore. Because Jesus has been one of us. No? And so he is a merciful high priest because he knows the evil of sin. For you had compassion for those who were in prison, and you cheerfully accepted the plundering of your possessions, knowing that you yourselves possess something better and more lasting. Do not therefore abandon that confidence of yours. It brings a great reward. So now he is telling the people, because you have received mercy, no, continue in your compassion also for those in prison. So already, at this early stage in our Christian history, Christians were taking care of the prisoners. Because that was one of the concerns of Jesus. I was in prison and you visited me. And that was one of his own mission, to proclaim liberty to captives. And he did not say the captives who were innocent, but all captives, all prisoners. Of course, in those times, there were many prisoners who were unjustly put into prison. But there were also prisoners who were justly put into prison. But he did not distinguish. As long as you are in prison, God takes care of you, and he identifies himself with all the prisoners. And the early Christians got that. That's why as early as this, when the letter to Hebrews was written, about 80 years after, no, 50 years after the resurrection of Jesus, and yet they were already doing that. And he was even telling them, continue to do that even if it would cost you something, like plundering of your possessions. You have to give of your possessions. You will have to save a great reward. So we should also be merciful. We have received mercy. Kaya as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Nakuha na natin kanina yan. Clothe as beloved, chosen ones, clothe yourself with compassion. That's why one thing that we should ask as we pray for a humble heart, we should also pray for a compassionate heart. That if this is the gift of tears, that we can be sorry for the others, feel sorry for them, that we are touched by their sufferings. Alam niyo po, there is this professional hazard that we have, the same as the doctors and the nurses, because they are always in the hospital and they are always in touch with sick people. It's easy for them, little by little, to lose the sense of compassion, pain, because they are always in touch with pain. Kaya baka nawala na yung awa. So, marami sa nakikita ng mga tao may sakit. No? So baka ganun na mangyari. Sa atin din, the same. Because we are in touch with grief. For example, hearing confessions. We always see, hear sins in confession. We might no longer, we may now lose the sense of the horror of sin. Ay, okay na yung ordinary na yung kasalanan. Or for you who are always in touch with the poor people, no, your students, hindi na kayo natatouch na kanilang kahirapan. Kasi ang dami na kayong mahihirap na. That's why we should really pray to the Lord that we may not lose, hindi tayo maging manhid. No? Na-immune na tayo sa kahirapan. Kasi bubog na tayo, no, sa ganitong karanasan. That's why clothe yourself with compassion, kindness, humility, and so on. For judgment will be without mercy to those anyone who has shown no mercy. But mercy triumphs over judgment. No. Kaya, ako'y, iwan po lang kung nalalaman ng mga congressmen natin na bumoto sa death penalty. If we can take this seriously, no, they will also receive no mercy. At ang nakakalungkot, no, during this debate on the lower house about the death penalty, maraming mga madre ay palaging nandoon, sinusubaybayan to make their presence felt. And in that votation on the second reading, that was March 1, Ash Wednesday, medyo natutuwa yung mga madre, no? Makita nila pagdating sa session. May mga krus. May mga abo sa loko nila. Ay, mananalo tayo sa votation. Nanalig sila sa simbahan. May mga abo sa loko. And yet, the majority of them voted for yes to death penalty. With the ashes on their forehead. What's the point? You receive the ash on your forehead as a symbol of the mercy of God, and then you cannot receive, give mercy to the others. Na kailangan silang patay. So yeah. Keep yourselves in the love of God. Look forward.